In this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to salvage your vertical videos to use on YouTube and remove those annoying black bars from the sides of your video, just like this. How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to my channel, where I help you understand the basics of filming and editing to up-level your video production and tell your story on YouTube. All right, so today I'm gonna show you four ways in order to use your vertical video footage that you may have used on your Instagram stories, your Snapchat stories, or your TikTok videos. And use them for your YouTube videos. My name is Kenneth and I have a small community on Twitter at lifestyle_KT that are all interested in enhancing their YouTube videos. If you wanna join my community there and wanna learn more about my personal tips and tricks about video editing and YouTube, go ahead and leave me a follow. Now, by the end of this video, I told you you are gonna learn the four ways to remove the black bars from your vertical videos, but stay tuned until the end because I'm gonna show you a way where you can use your vertical video footage on YouTube without having to incorporate any of these fixes. And without further ado,
let's do this.
Fix number one, zoom and blur. The most common way that people fix these black bar issues on their vertical videos is the zoom and blur. A lot of people use this technique as it is the easiest and most common way to fix the black bar issue. Even a lot of clips in the news are done this way. So the issue I have with this technique is that it just does not look natural to me. But if you wanna go this route, I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to do it. All right, so first of all, you need to import your clip onto the video editor of your choice. Mine today is going to be Adobe Premiere Pro. All right, so all you have to do is copy the clip that you have onto a layer behind the main video. In Premiere Pro, you can do this by copying and pasting the clip to the new layer, or you can hold the Option key and then drag and drop that clip onto the new layer. Then you gotta select the clip on the bottommost layer and zoom it in, scale it all the way up until the black bars are gone. So now all you have to do is blur the background clip and it'll give you this image of the black bars being replaced by a blurred clip. You could probably incorporate a little bit more tweaks to it in order to make it a little bit more better, but by the end of the day, it's going to look more or less about the same. Now, a fix that is a little less common is fix number two, side and text. All right, so this method is simply going to be moving the clip to one side, either to left or right, then using the other space for other media, such as text or another video. So for the text, you could include a description of the video clip, or you could even put subtitles so the viewers can understand what the person is saying. It's a pretty simple fix that I don't really see used quite as often. All right, now to fix number three, sidebar match. So the third method is called sidebar match and it's similar to fix number one. But instead of using a copy of the same clip, you could use a totally different clip that matches the context of the video. So for example, if I have a clip on the beach or an underwater clip, I can use a similar underwater video that I could replace the black bars like this. It doesn't look the most pleasing to the eye either, but it does beat the black bars being there instead. And my favorite method for eliminating the black bars on these video clips is called the pick and pick corner pinning. From the name of it, it sounds super complicated, but it is simply just strategically placing your vertical video footage into a section of a still image in order to make it aesthetically pleasing. This is my favorite fix because you have an endless amount of still images to choose from, and you can go as creative as you want with this idea. All right, so let me show you how to do it. Let's dive back into Premiere Pro. All right, so here we have that vertical clip that we want to use. Let me just go ahead and get that still image that we want to corner pin that video clip to. All right, so here it is, a photo of an iPhone. Keep in mind, you can do whatever you want. You could put it in a window frame, you could put it in an iPad, whatever you feel floats your boat. All right, let's put the iPhone still image in a layer underneath the main video clip, like what we did in the other fixes. Okay, now we want to move the video clip into the section that you want it to be. A Okay, now that we have it here, it kind of looks a little bit unnatural still. So what we want to do is do the corner pinning method. We can transform the image to match the space on the screen on the iPhone. It distorts the image to make it a little bit more natural to the human eye. And there you go. And again, you have an unlimited amount of ways to implement this fix onto your video. So be creative as possible. Now that we have gone through all the fixes that I have for you to fix your vertical videos, there's actually one more option. If you do not want to do the work required to do those fixes, you can actually upload your vertical video footage straight onto YouTube. If your entire video is vertical, YouTube actually now recognizes that format and removes the black bars for you. However, your viewers will actually be watching your video in the vertical format with their phone. But do keep in mind that your entire video has to be vertical. This won't work if you have a horizontal video and you just want to insert a vertical clip for a small portion of that video. Alright, so make sure you hit that notification bell down below, because in next week's video, I'm going to be teaching you how to organize your video files in order to streamline your editing. As always, I hope you learned at least one thing from this video in regards to using vertical video footage on your channel. And I want you to go into the comment section below and leave a comment on which fix you are going to be using the next time you are going to use a vertical video on your channel. And on that note, that is all I have for you this week, so I will see you all next Monday.